Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic hyperconjugation. Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have studied about the resonance, and we have also did the type of resonance, that is positive resonance and negative resonance. So resonance is based on the delocalization of pi electrons. So similar to that, even the hyperconjugation, the topic that we are going to talk about, even that is also the delocalization of electrons. But what is the difference between these two, and what is actually hyperconjugation? Let us talk about it. So before understanding what is hyperconjugation, we should understand that what is the definition of the hyperconjugation. So let us understand what does that means. And that means that the delocalization of electrons due to overlap between a p orbital and a sigma bond, that is the alpha carbon and hydrogen carbon and hydrogen atom, is called as the hyperconjugation. So let us give a more detail about that, how the hyperconjugation or how the delocalization of electron takes place. So for which we have another detail, that is the hyperconjugation occurs only if the sigma bond and the empty p orbital have proper orientation. So therefore this kind of delocalization of the electrons from that the sigma bond, because in we know that in any kind of bond there are two electrons that are being involved. One it would be of one atom, while the other one would be of another atom. But since we are talking about the sigma bond, that is is based on the covalent bond, and that is the reason that the two electrons or the shared electrons that would be transferred or that could be delocalized on the empty p orbital, and this kind of delocalization is basically known as hyperconjugation. We are going to do a example of that also, so as to understand that what is and how the hyperconjugation occurs. And moving towards the further thing, that is the electrons of the sigma bond enter into the partial conjugation with unshared p orbital or with the attached unsaturated system. So therefore this is an example there where we could see that the electrons that is because of the sigma bond, and they also delocalize in such a manner that they even could delocalize to a that is conjugated system which consists of unshared p electrons, or to and that could be attached to an unsaturated system, so even that could be shared with that also. So related to this, we are going to do a more lectures in the future, and let us understand that how does the hyperconjugation occurs. So for that, let me give you an example. So this is a very small example that I am giving you, and suppose in this case, suppose we have a particular kind of species basically known as ethyl cation, suppose, and that is what I am going to explain, and from which we could easily understand that how the hyperconjugation occurs. So this is the ethyl cation, if you would say, then talking about the carbon atoms that are being involved in this case are of different hybridization. And as you could see over this carbon is the one which is showing the sp3 hybridization. While talking about this carbon atom, this is the one that will show sp2 hybridization. The reason behind that is, let us focus on this carbon atom, because in this carbon atom only we could get the empty p orbital, and from that would be very much easy to understand that how the hyperconjugation will occur. And let me explain about this carbon atom. So talking about the atomic weight of carbon, it has been known as C6. So we could write the electronic configuration in terms of that is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2. So this is for the carbon atom that has a valency of 4 that we know. So if I draw the representation of the orbitals that have been present in the s subshell as well as in p subshell. So in this case, I will get to know that is the number of electrons that have been present in the carbon or the second shell that is in S subshell. It is basically 2 electrons, while that of this P subshell consists of also 2 electrons, but the electrons are of different orbitals, means one is of PX and one is of PY. And so this is what I have. And what if we have excited this electron? So after excitation, we could see that after excitation, again the orbital will be the same as it is. There would be no change in the orbital, but we could see that this electron, which was earlier present in the s orbital, it would jump to the last orbital, and meanwhile this electron there will be as it is. So this is what we have mentioned over here. But talking about the carbon, which is having a positive charge, So this is occurring when a particular kind of electronegative atom would have been attached over here, as well as that electronegative atom would have grabbed the electron of the carbon and making this carbon to be more electropositive. And that is the thing that among this four, one of the electron will be removed, and that is the reason that we could see that for carbon C plus, if I would say like this one, that means because one electron has been removed, and here we could see that still three bonds, three electrons are being remaining, just so as to form the bond with two hydrogens and one carbon atom of the methyl one. So after this thing, we could get to know that is the electron has been lost in this case, and that's the reason that only three electrons are being remaining. That is one, here it is again two, and this one is the third one. So therefore, this is the orbitals that consist of electrons that are been remaining, and that's the reason that they will mix with each other, or the mixing of the orbitals would take place, and that's the reason that we could get sp2 hybridization, or sp2 hybridized carbon atom, and that is nothing but for carbocation that we could see over here. So now this sp2 hybrid carbon atom will form a particular structure that is very similar to that of the any kind of molecule that shows sp2 hybridization, that is basically trigonal planar, and that is what I am going to show you. And from that only, or from that basis, we could understand that how the that is hyperconjugation will take place. So this was a detail that it was very much necessary for us to understand, and after that, let us understand that how the hyperconjugation occurs. So based on this thing, we have got to know that the methyl group that we that was been attached with this carbon atom or this carbocation, it was basically sp3 hybridized. So therefore, the structure of that would be basically tetrahedral, and that could be represented. I cannot represent it on a 2D diagram, but the representation could be done in such a way that we could understand that that is present in a tetrahedral geometry. So let us make the structure of that one. So it consists of basically three hydrogen atoms. The methyl carbon atom would consist of three hydrogen atoms that are been arranged in this way. So just for instance, suppose if I am drawing in this way, this is what we have got. And talking about the another one, that is, this is the carbocation that it has been formed, that is the one which has a positive charge. But since it is the carbocation that has been showcasing the sp2 hybridization, so that's the reason that it would be a trigonal planar, and that's what we could see, that it would form bond between this two hydrogen atoms, as you could see, and this would be in a planar structure, while this one would be an overall tetrahedral structure when it comes to the carbon atom, which is of the methyl one. And talking about the NTP orbital, that is what the main thing that we are going to talk about. So as we move on with the electronic configuration or kind of hybridization that would have taken place over here, so therefore here we could see an MPP orbital has been remaining, so therefore it could be PZ mostly. So therefore this PZ empty orbital, it remains as it is, and that kind of the PZ orbital, or that kind of the MPP orbital, it will be perpendicular to the triangular planar. So therefore, suppose if this is the planar one, that is this carbon, hydrogen, hydrogen, and this carbon, they make a planar trigonal geometry shape, and the talking about the next, that is the p orbital, which is empty, that will be perpendicular to the planar one. And if this is planar that we have got for the carbon, hydrogen, and the carbon, and we could see that this is the empty p orbital. And talking about the next, that is, if this one is called to be the alpha carbon atom, and that's the reason that the bond between this carbon and this hydrogen can be called as sigma. So even this sigma bond will have a kind of orientation. Even this sigma bond will have an orientation, because it is made up of the p orbitals, as we know, because of the hybridization also. And that is the case that this carbon will form a kind of bond because of the sp3 hybridized, and even this is because of the p orbital that we could get over here, and or because of the sp3 hybrid orbitals that we would get over here. And that's the reason that we could find that this orbital, which consists of two electrons, as you could see over here, it consists of two electrons. So that two electrons is very aligned with that of the MPP orbital, and they are very close to each other. So that's the reason that there could be a delocalization of electron from this sigma bond to this empty p orbital, and this kind of delocalization of the electrons that are being present in a sigma bond to a one which is electron deficient, if we could say, or the one which consists of empty p orbital. So that kind of the delocalization is basically known as hyperconjugation. And in this case, we could see that after the electron has been transferred towards that one, that is towards this empty p orbital, then we could see that this carbon atom would get stabilized, because as we know that the carbon which is highly positive, or which consists of positive charge, which consists of negative charge, obviously they are the species, they are reactive species, and they are having a short-lived species, but because of which they could also be stabilized. But meanwhile, we could see that this hydrogen will get positive because the electron of the hydrogen has been transferred to the empty p orbital. And this kind of process will go on, and that's the thing that we could say that the hyperconjugation will take place. And just as suppose if this hydrogen is become positive, so the next sigma bond that it has is because of the hydrogen and this carbon. Even this will transfer over here so as to make it stabilize, and again this one will become positive. And so as to stabilize this one, again the sigma bond that is between this carbon and this hydrogen, it will delocalize on this one, and now this hydrogen will get positive. So therefore, this kind of the delocalization, it will go on, and that kind of thing is basically known as hyperconjugation, which makes it to be very much similar to that of the resonance that we have did. But only the difference between these two, that is resonance and the hyperconjugation, is in resonance the shifting of pi electrons was been taking place in the overall reaction, and making the carbon atoms or the other atoms position as it is, and that is the difference. And it was dealing with the pi bonds or pi electrons, but now this hyperconjugation, it deals with the sigma bonds or sigma electrons. So that makes them the two difference, and that's it I wanted to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood hyperconjugation very well, and you share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to eGeta channel. Thank you so much.